Hey, RV family, keep it high, keep it tight. My name is Jay Morris, the review guy, reviewing music for the love of music, and I'm back again to bring you another video. And in this one, I'm covering the new Five Finger Death Punch album entitled F8. This is the appropriately named 8th studio-length album by the Las Vegas, Nevada hard rock and heavy metal, thrash metal, groove metal band Five Finger Death Punch. The more purist fans that watch my channel, and I do have some, are going to expect me to come on here, lambast the band, talk about Ivan, talk about how stupid they are, talk about how dumb their sound is. Because all in all, they're kind of like Nickelback. Hating Five Finger Death Punch is just in style. But to really look at this record, I want to give the band a fair chance, and I'm not going to sit here and I'm not gonna just shit talk the band up and down, because I try to keep that away from my channel. I try to keep it somewhat positive. Even in negative reviews, I try to highlight the points that I think are good and bad. I just genuinely plan on giving my in-depth analysis of the band and why I think this album is on a teeter-totter. I should also point out that one of the reasons I'm not wanting to be overly critical in a rude way is because this band does have fans, this band does have an established sound, and to just write them off as a band entirely is just wrong in my opinion. Maybe other people feel differently, I don't know. Because all in all, talking about this album in particular, it really isn't super different than what they've done before, and that can be seen as a good or bad thing depending on if you're a fan of the band and their consistency, or if you want them to do something different. So number one on the list, production. If I could have one request, it would just be, can Five Finger Death Punch manage to not make all of their songs sound like stadium rock bait that are trying to sound as epic as possible? See, I've seen them live. Their charisma live is flawless. But an album ain't a fucking stage. I mean, only a few of these tracks are gonna be played on tour. Most of the time, bands diversify their set list with different albums. So how is it that almost all of their albums, if not every single album, are full to the brim with tracks that are literally overflowing with melodrama and camp? More than one intro on this album makes me cringe a little bit, makes me wince a little bit. They're just trying so hard to build up tension with these intros. Tracks like Inside Out, Living the Dream, and Bottom of the Top are great examples of this. With percussion that is so instantaneously, unnecessarily grisly, and riffs that are just trying so way too hard to be meaty. And this would be perfectly fine if Five Finger Death Punch tracks have not become a little bit indistinguishable, at least from one another nowadays. It's a little mind-boggling, because their tracks have always had a great deal of camp, but I can't really remember a time where they've been this hard to tell apart. It's not as bad as super mainstream rock like Imagine Dragons and Fall Out Boy, which barely qualifies rock nowadays, but it is reaching a level of so much compression, and when you're performing in these genres, have a bit of rawness, have a bit of organic instrumentation. I'm not saying they don't play instrumentation, of course they do. I'm saying make it sound organic. It sounds so clean, it sounds so fucking groomed that I can't stand it half the time. I mean, take some of the bands that Five Finger Death Punch themselves have said they take inspiration from. Like, I remember Zoltan Bathory said that some of the influences from the band are Pantera, Sepultura, which those aren't hard influences to see. They bleed through their sound clear as day. They had just the right amount of production. They sounded raw in their aggression, in their antisocial lyrics, in their socio-political lyrics. You felt their aggression, you felt their rage. And I don't want to say it sounds fake here, it just sounds so industry groomed. To the point to where it's made to sound so lifeless, and what's left behind through this production is just a husk of what maybe was a good track to begin with. Number two, lyricism. All right, can we just talk about for a second how many Five Finger Death Punch tracks boil down to,
you don't fucking know what it's like, you don't fucking know me.
Either that or,
I'm alone, I'm a lone wolf, I'm a lone fucking wolf.
And going into this record, I was like, maybe the lyrics are gonna be a little bit better. But the track Inside Out solidified that and proved my point. Gonna read a couple lyrics here. I stand alone. Guess I knew it all along. Yes, I knew that you were wrong. And then a bit after, I want you to say, it was never really me. You just turned and walked away. And they stretch that me rhyme. They go like, me. Not only are the lyrics on this track and most of this album some of the most cliche Five Finger Death Punch lyrics I've ever heard in my life, but also so disingenuous in the way they are phrased. Like, it's like they're just going to Rhyme Zone and finding whatever rhyme times in something that resembles a story. And more times than not, they don't really tell that good of a story, or even any story that is describable or unique. And that is counting a linear fashion. Linear fashion and songwriting and storytelling is not a bad thing, but they're not doing it in a linear or a, you know, like a free verse or a linear type way or a complex way. And don't get me wrong, there are bands that do antisocial and fuck you to the world, middle fingers up type lyricism. I mean, that is literally a staple in metal and rock. But Five Finger Death Punch's version of it is just becoming so hard to discern. And also on the second verse of Inside Out, I want to read something. I'm not a dog. I'm not a slave. It doesn't matter how much money I get paid. Don't give a shit. I never did, so you can wipe away that stupid fucking grin. I won't quote any more lyrics, but can I point something out about this? And I had to listen to it multiple times to make this assessment. The pacing of this verse, the McDonald's drive-thru effect thrown on Ivan's vocals, it sounds like champagne. I can't be the only one hearing this. It sounds like it's ripped straight from champagne. And that leads me into the third and final point of this kind of three-stage thing. Their derivative with their own identity. Which I guess kind of ties into the whole Sepultura Pantera thing. They're obviously wearing their influences on their sleeve. You can clearly, though, tell a Five Finger Death Punch track when it comes on. It's clear as day whether it's a ballad, whether it's a heavy track. Which, might I say, this record does have some good ballads. Darkness Settles In and Brighter Side of Grey are two of their best, but that's besides the point. They're fully recognizable. Their tracks are fully recognizable, but for all the wrong reasons. The overcompression, the way they crush their whole sound down, they begin to sound so commercially viable that it's like every stage of their sound is groomed. It's not like I can pick out something that is able to carry these tracks. The instrumentation is not only derivative of other bands, but derivative of their own sound. The production is so crushing, it's so groomed, it's so compressed, it's so fat, but in the wrong ways. It's lifeless, to say the least. The lyricism is some of the most trope-filled lyricism that you're gonna hear. Ivan has pretty good vocals, but his growled vocals get really repetitive and really tedious throughout this album, and don't have enough dynamics to carry it. And I think one important thing to note is the bonus track, Making Monster. Go listen to this track. Why do you think it's a bonus? It is one of my favorite Five Finger Death Punch tracks. It is heavy, it's blistering, it doesn't sound commercially viable for the most part. It has progression and technicality throughout it. The production is booming. Ivan really flexes his vocal muscles. But it doesn't quite sound like it could be a hit, does it? I wonder. I wanna like this album. I do. But after a few listens, it just gets mind-numbing. One of the things that I should point out about this record that is pretty much universal for all of Five Finger Death Punch's albums for me is how the replay value isn't super strong, in the sense that I think they work better in a single vicinity. They have catchy songs that are really sweet to listen to, very chunky, but as you listen to numerous Five Finger Death Punch tracks in a row, especially on this record, it just ends up becoming extremely repetitive and tedious. I mean, I'll probably get dislike bombed, but from fans of the band, I have to be honest, which I've been dislike bombed many times, so feel free. F8 is a Five Finger Death Punch record through and through. I just think they're starting to go through the motions. They're making songs that sound like their past material, but worse. And I don't know. I hope I made my points clear. I tried to make it as concise as possible, because unlike most reviews, it's kind of difficult to sit and go through all the songs. It would honestly feel like I'm just saying things you could apply to any of their songs from any of their albums. Yeah, honestly, I'm gonna be giving this album a 4 out of 10. And that is a wrap. Have you heard this new Five Finger Death Punch record, F8? Let me know in the comment section below if you did. I'd love to discuss the record with you. Maybe you felt differently about it, which is perfectly fine. I'd love to hear it if you loved. Be sure to like this video if you enjoyed it. Subscribe to join the review family today and smash that notification bell to be notified of my future uploads. You know who it is. My name is Jay Morris, the review guy, and I'm signing off saying fair. Go ahead, live your best life.